And that's not good.
Right. These trusts worried people. So Teddy Roosevelt started breaking up the big companies and earned himself the nickname Trust Buster.
If something stinks in the business world,
give him a shout!
Trust Buster!
If monopolies make you wanna hurl, give him a shout!
Trust Buster! I'm gonna bust me trust!
If corporate greed gets way too big, give him a shout!
Trust Buster!
When robber barons act like greedy pigs, give him a shout!
Trust Buster!
I'm gonna bust me a trust!
Give him a shout!
Trust Buster!
If J.P. Morgan makes a sneaky bargain, give him a shout! Trust Buster!
I'm gonna bust me a trust!
Rockefeller's cornered the market! Give him a shout!
Trust Buster!
If you've eaten the dust of a powerful trust, you'd better shout! Trust Buster!
Something. Trust Buster makes me feel good.
So if you want the man, he'll do all he can. You know you gotta shout, Trust Buster. Ow! Give him a shout, Trust Buster. Give him a shout, Trust Buster. Give him a shout, Trust Buster. Give him a shout, Trust Buster.
I'm looking now, and still looking, and I'm looking some more, but, oh, what a surprise. I'm not finding what I'm looking for. Here I have a $1 bill with Washington on it. And here's a fiver with Lincoln on it. But as hard as I try, I can't seem to find that $100,000 bill with my picture on it. I think that stinks, don't you? Here I am, Woodrow Wilson, 28th President of the United States in 1918, the man who guided this nation through World War I, who won a Nobel Peace Prize, and even created the Federal Reserve Bank that issues this nation's money. And what did those ingrates do? They stick me on the $100,000 bill. Like you're really gonna use one of those to buy a hoo-hoo or a bubble up at your local Winn-Dixie. Well, I'm fed up. Go ahead, take my money. Take all of it, I don't care. Take that bum Alexander Hamilton. You see him an awful lot on the 10. He was never even president.
I should have been. You see, it's sad, really. Aaron Burr shot me dead. Sad.
Oh, and Ben Franklin. Don't get me started on him. He's on the 100.
Well, like I always say, 100 saved is 100 earned, you know?
Yeah, terrific.
You know, instead of having money on me, I'm on money.
I mean, the whole ordeal has me extremely upset. That's why I've come up with this. The $12 bill. Sure, it sounds strange, but think about it. There's 12 months in a year and 12 inches in a foot. Why not a $12 bill? Just listen to what a few happy customers say.
It beats the heck out of the 10!
It's super for paying my below minimum wage child labor for a 12-hour day.
$12 bill. I recommend it. I use it. I make it.
Misinformation in Histeria.
The date, June 17th, 1972. The place, the Watergate Hotel in Washington, D.C., where burglars were caught breaking into the offices of the Democratic National Committee. It was an election year, and they were trying to steal files about the Democrats' election strategy.